Riding a 10-game winning streak, the top-ranked women's hockey team hits the road for a series at Bemidji State this weekend. Both Friday and Saturday's games start at 3 p.m. Head coach Mark Johnson is here. We'll have some opening comments and take questions.
Certainly happy with the way we played the six periods Friday night and then coming back Saturday afternoon. All phases of our game were pretty good, and as we move forward and get ready for Bemidji, I don't know if I'd throw my fishing pole in. Last time, I think we were up in February there, they had a fishing tournament going on right outside our hotel on Lake Bemidji, and I've never seen so many trucks on a frozen lake in my life and huts. And well, the winner, I think, was getting $10,000 for the tournament, so I was thinking maybe sticking it in there. It's not quite as long as a hockey stick, so might be able to get something out of it.
Mark, your power play has been a little higher than potent here the last seven games, more goals in the last seven than you had in on the power play leading up to it this season. Has there been a tactical change? Has there been a schematic change? Why is it working so well at this point?
Well, the puck's gone in the last, 3 or 4 weekends. In simple terms, that's probably the biggest reason. But I think over the course of the season, you look at film, and Jackie spent some time the last couple of weeks with the two different groups, as well as Dan, and look at little things. You practice it, maybe a little bit on Tuesday, and you practice it on Wednesday quite a bit. And it's the ability of your players to read what's given to you out there. Obviously, you have five people. If you have the puck, you can outnumber them, and you try to outnumber them as the puck gets to the net and give yourself an opportunity. We made a couple changes, obviously, with Chandler not playing both games this past weekend and her being a big part of our second unit. We made some adjustments there. Both nights, we put Mauerman out there, and both nights she scored power play goals. So we thought about maybe having a left-hander, which was Mauerman, and giving her an opportunity instead of, whether it was Shaver or Norby, both right-handed, and it seemed to work. And so it's nice to have the different phases of our game, whether it's the penalty killing, our five-on-five play in the neutral zone, or the power play. If things are flowing in those three areas, chances are you're in a real good position to win a hockey game.
Another shutout for Anne Renee this weekend. And just generally, what have you seen from her this year with the injuries that she's been able to replicate her play essentially from last year, despite that?
I just think her overall commitment continues to move upward. I mean, I think last couple weekends, especially for our seniors, they can probably see the end of their careers here at Wisconsin. And I think this past weekend, compared to our weekend against North Dakota, I thought Anne Renee was probably a little more focused this past weekend. And so, a lot of it is how the athletes prepare themselves, either for practice and/or for games. And I think her preparation this year has probably been equal, or maybe a little bit better than it has been in the past. And I think as she prepares, and unfortunately, when you're injured, you have to spend a little bit more time preparing. Obviously, whether it's for practice, it takes longer to warm up and get themselves ready, and certainly the same situation for a game. So for her, it's all about preparation. And I think she's done a great job, and certainly one of the reasons probably she's been as successful this year as she was last year.
Mentioned without Melissa, the power play. How did you play defensively without her, and did the defenders step in and play pretty well in her absence?
Yeah, Friday night, Maddie Rowe, we've used sporadically, whether at right wing or at defense, played a regular shift on the blue line, ended up scoring a goal. I think played really well, and that's what you look for. I mean, she's been around now for almost three quarters of a season. She seems to be much more comfortable. She's made a lot of strides. She's really improved as a player since we started in September. And so now she got a real major opportunity, and she took advantage of it. So that was nice to see from a coaching perspective. And I'm not sure when Melissa's going to be back, but it was nice to see Maddie step in both Friday and then come back Saturday and play big minutes and do well.
Over on the left.
And sort of pursuant to that, with such a small roster relative to how many people play each game, how helpful is it to have players like Maddie Rowe who can play with the forwards, play with the defense, and be sort of flexible like that?
I think that's been one of our strengths as we've gone through the season, and we've had kids off representing, you know, whether it's Canada or the United States in different tournaments. When Pankowski missed four games and Gogan was injured for five or six games, you know, we've had other players been able to step up and do a real nice job of making a contribution, not only playing but scoring goals and making plays and getting assists. So the deeper you are in those categories, the better you're going to be, because over the course of the winter, you're going to run into situations, whether they're injuries or kids missing or people getting sick. The deeper you are, certainly coaches really enjoy that. When you're healthy, it creates a problem because everybody wants to play, but I'd rather have that problem than and not be as deep as we have been.
Andy?
Mark, I know you don't get too focused on rankings, but you're unanimous number one. The fact that you have played five opponents that are in the top 10, how is that reflected in how you guys have done this year? You would think that some benefit has come from that type of competition.
Yeah, I think early on, you know, we had to go out to Clarkson, you know, a team that's, you know, won the NCAA championship. They've been in the Frozen Four. We're playing them in their building. Those type of games, especially if you're successful, you know, you really can take some confidence out of it. You learn about your club. You learn about different players. You certainly learn about your younger players in that environment because they're going to get tested. And so having them early on in the season and then having Cornell back here, again, a team that's, you know, history has been very strong. And I think when you do play top teams, whether it's Minnesota in our league or Duluth or this past couple weekends when we played North Dakota, teams that, you know, historically have been very strong, I mean, you find a lot about your club, where you are, find out about your players. And at the end of the weekend, as a coaching staff, you can look at this film and, you know, really reflect on where you are, you know, what you've done well, and probably most importantly, you know, how do we get better at what we're doing? And so those early tests and certainly our non-conference schedule has been very helpful. Obviously, winning the games is a big confidence booster, but next day, next practice, next game, how do we get better? And that's the whole process of the season, seeing we started in early September and now we're almost into February.
Anything else for Coach?
All right. Thank you.
Thanks, Mark.